Wait a minute. If you read over there, Jeremiah, God said now it's going to be 70 years.
That's what it said. That's what it
but
said.
But this preacher's name, whose name is Yah is gracious. Hell no. I mean, he got ready to perform. See, it, and nothing wrong with going when he said go. But you better go knowing what he said. And not what nobody else out there saying that's popular and it gets you over in their eyesight. Let's see what God said right here now. I want to tell you now. Because in other words, this is the etymology of this. He coming. Babylon, in other words, that whole thing. He coming. Because we've been hard-headed. That's the only reason he sent him there. After, look, Nebuchadnezzar, all the people fired up, believing this man instead of what God has said. Let's see what he said on down the road. You heard this when he said, send me. He just said, go. Go to this people. Tell them now, yeah, I mean, y'all think you understand, but you understand not. No, you build up all these things because some man told you
some
this.
Man,
and it has nothing to do with the word of God.
Yes,
well, you got to jump the pews. Where is that in God's word?
Nowhere.
You got to speak in tongues. Now, you speak it in tongues when you're talking to them. It's language is what it means. What we have to understand, if you believe that, then you'll fall in this camp because Hananiah. See, his name means God is gracious. Got all the credentials, but he's not talking for God.
No, sir.
Let's see what it says here, y'all.
No, sir.
See, when God sends you, he's not sending you unequipped.
No,
but now what will happen if you let the Hananiahs of the world or the foolishness of this world begin to cloud your heart, you start spewing nonsense. Had nothing to do with it. This is why I tell every mother in here, if your child wants to take communion when we have it, don't go by what you heard over in Primrose Lane over there. I want you to tell me, and I will never override your rights. But I'm going to tell you, if they want it, I'll give it to them because they may not totally understand it like you think the world, because you can't have communion because you didn't. That's traditions of men. I'm going to ask you a question. If that child asks me for communion and I don't give it to them, and then they go out and something happens to them and they die, how you going to feel and how I'm going to feel?
Amen.
Don't let all this tradition of men. If that child has an unction, even if they don't quite understand it, ain't going to hurt if you let other food get down them Big Macs and all that mess. They're getting ready to commune with God.
Amen.
They're getting ready to eat the representation of God's body that heals you. His blood that covers you. And you, but yet you'll go out and then they start blowing up and then you'll get on their case. You need to lose the weight, but you gave him the Big Macs and fries. See what I'm saying? Because you let Big Macs eat the little clown to get all wired up. Now you still have to have some discipline now.
Yes, sir.
Listen now. Here's what the thing is, it never came in over 2 years, and the prophet Jeremiah went his way, didn't he? Then the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah, the prophet. After that, Hananiah, the prophet, look what the prophet did. God put a yoke on him, a present from God. I don't know about y'all, but I mean a present from God. And Mr. Big Shot got so wound up in himself, let's see what he did. See, there's nothing wrong with being sent by God and understanding what God done for you. But now if you start ego tripping, then you got a problem.
Yes.
Remember, what he done for you, he'll do for others.
Yes, sir.
I think we sang it sometime.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Now looking at this. Then the word came unto Jeremiah the prophet. After that, Hananiah the prophet had broken the yoke from off of the neck of the prophet Jeremiah, saying, go and tell, this is what God told him. God said, that man must be out of his mind. I gave you that gift. Oh, are you beginning to see something? You might not like the gift this other person, but God gave it to him. Try to break it. Try to interfere with it. Try to kill that minister. You must be out of your mind. This is what God telling him. He said, go tell Hananiah, saying, thus said the Lord, thou hast broken the yoke of wood. Listen at this now. But thou shalt make for them the yoke of iron. Say, you go ahead now. I'm going to put some iron around you, Jack, and ain't nobody can take that off. For thus said the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I have put a yoke of iron upon the neck of all these nations, or all these ethnos.
Yes, sir.
The ones, the Kenites, and all these folks trying to tell you this, that, and other, and so forth. That they may serve, even God, when God say, I ain't putting one of my folk, that they may serve Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and they shall serve him, because you've been a hardhead.
Yeah.
But I'm going to take care of you while you're there. They grew that when you did what they supposed to, if you didn't understand. And I have given him the beast of the fields also. And see, Nebuchadnezzar, if you done a little study, his britches got too big, and God had to jack him up too. Listen now. Then said the prophet Jeremiah unto Hananiah, the prophet. Look here now. You've been prophesying, but you better hear this one. Hear now, Hananiah, the Lord, all caps, I don't know about the young, that's daddy, have not sent thee. You hear what they're saying now? If God say 70 years, I don't care what I say, you say, he, she, it says, it's going to be exactly what he said. The Lord had not sent thee, but thou makest this people to trust in a lie. Don't ever do that.
Please don't.
Ministers, you or anybody. Don't, you know, some folks get to test the line trying to make themselves, but don't do that. It's too dangerous. He says, this people to trust in a lie. Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I will cast thee from off the face of the earth. Is that plain enough for y'all?
Yes, sir. Yes.
This is why I can't play up here. This ain't no playtime. I'm not here to make you feel like you were. No, no. I'm here to tell you what God said. And he said, I'm going to do it this year. Now, so it's no misunderstanding. Thou shalt die. And I ain't trying to be speaking to all many of my brothers in the gospel. Some of them are not here because they caused people to believe in a lie.
Well,
they told things, didn't have nothing to do with God, but it had to do with some denominational whatever.
Speak Holy Spirit.
I will respect all men of God, won't judge any of them, but if it don't line up with the word of God, it's not right.
Amen.
Nobody can tell God what he can and cannot do. That's what this preacher tried to do. I mean, his name, even his name just reeked of old law. But he was dead wrong. And see, that was because thou hast taught. Is that plain up there? That's why I have to be very careful, because if you ever read Moore's, hey, if you're teaching, more is required of you. I don't think they understand what they're saying. When I said the Lord called me to teach the word, I understood what I was doing. I can't afford to teach you nothing but taught rebellion against who? Who did he teach rebellion against? The Lord. He told them, I'm going to break the yoke. The Lord told me the yoke going to be broken 2 years. What does that sound like on television? Break the yoke. They be hollering and screaming about, you're going to get this in 6 months. They don't have any. They don't know.
They don't know.
I'm sorry. If you want to believe that, have a nice trip. But if it don't line up with the word, if God says 70 years and this guy says 6 months, ain't going to work. And I think she read that over. I know what my plans are towards you, to live love and peace and give you an expected end. I don't care if you want to visit elect with some of the